So for this week's trade of the week, we're going to have a bit of a recap on the markets we looked at last week, really. Just a bit of an update on what's going on there. So starting off with sterling against the Japanese yen on the daily chart. Just to recap, we were short from here, trade against the trend, so not expecting prices to come all the way down to the bottom of the price envelope, really looking for prices to expire, the trade to run out of steam before hitting target, which is pretty much what it's done. So entering here, 1-1 was down to about here. It actually moved another 100 points beyond that. Great trade, really lovely 300 point winner there on sterling yen, and a great opportunity there. From that level, the market's found support, as one would expect in an uptrending market. That's actually led to a buy on Friday night. Difficult to jump into this trade given that it's a Japanese bank holiday today. But having said that, obviously with all the data in the news in the US going on, fiscal, you know, the debt ceiling and so on, at the end of the day, it signaled a trade. This is what we call a continuation trade here on Friday's close. So we're long from 157.16, and we're going to see what happens. So we'll see how this goes for the rest of, for the next week or two. Moving through to Euro CAD, we talked about this last week. Just hit the ultimate target on Thursday. Looking back to this long trade that we had here on the 16th of September, originally hit this target for last week. Then subsequently hit that ultimate top of the price envelope target up there, hit that on Thursday, spiked it, rejected it. I think it's fascinating up here. I think we could get some opportunities to sell. We've got to wait. We haven't had the trade signaled yet, but I think it's brewing for something going on. It's sort of the quiet before the storm almost. So keep an eye on EuroCAD, everybody. If it can hold that level and stay below 140.80, it could lead to some interesting shorts. But for us trend signal users, we're sitting on our hands, having just taken profits there on about a 330 point winner there. Moving through to another market, which is again a Canadian dollar, dollar CAD. We talked about this last week. Now last week we were here, 130.13, and it's moved a whopping 40 points. Woohoo! It's you know, not so exciting, and again it's still a bit dull and dreary. Moved up nicely in the early part of last week, and then of course we came through to Friday and we just sort of, you know, two steps forward and two steps back, really. But we're still up on side of it, and we're expecting prices to continue a little bit further north. So we're setting and forgetting. We're expecting prices to continue higher, maybe even up to this sort of low 105 area there. So we'll be keeping an eye on that one to push to higher prices, but in the right direction nonetheless. Looking back further now to the indices, we talked about these last week as well. Dow, S&P's coming down really nicely, achieving that ultimate target on the Dow there. Not really expecting a move to that extent, quite frankly. S&P's is rather more what we expected. But the market came down and then generated a buy on Friday's close. And then also looking through to the S&P's as well, giving us a continuation buy as well on the S&P's. So nice opportunity to sell. Lovely profit again on the S&P's. And some decent profits to be had there as well. So a few trades out there. I think be very careful on these indices right now. I think you've got them all tracking higher. All of them are giving potential buys. And what with the debt ceiling we've got and data going on about that this week, could lead to some volatility. So if you are going to be getting into some of these US indices off the daily charts, just keep that risk a little bit low, just ahead of that data there, and just keep your stops in. Otherwise, FTSE as well, looking relatively interesting, as I'm sure really all the indices are, really. We call this in Thursday's workshop to be looking for a bounce here. This was Thursday in the morning, looking at prices down here. Really, down there, VIX was very high, something we talked to our Trendsignal customers about, particularly useful when trading FTSE. It starts getting a little bit more complicated. I don't want to talk about it in too much detail, but nonetheless, we were talking about buying it back on Thursday last week. And here we are now, about 170 points higher from those levels. So considerable rally, and then a lot of potential upside to be had there. Ultimately, it depends on the old debt ceiling in the US. But we'll see. You know, we're Monday. We've had a buy on Friday night. We'll see what happens. So that's where we are on the daily chart. Some interesting moves really just transpiring as we speak. So likes of sterling yen giving signals, euro CAD brewing for something, dollar CAD as dull as ditch water, and some interesting moves potentially ahead of the old debt ceiling stuff later on this week. Have a good week, everybody, and speak soon. Bye-bye.
If you would like more information about trading the right way, TrendSignal is giving you the opportunity to see and hear about its services live at a free online seminar. Take a look at the TrendSignal website for the latest events and to book your free place.